find data about the ratio of omega 6s and 3s in butter in 1960, which is a reasonably good ratio. Butter wasn't such a bad food in Normandy when I was growing up. Pork, beef, eggs, and this is in 2000. The butter has become a pro-inflammatory food. The worst offender are eggs. Eggs on my Normandy farm when I was a kid were a health food filled with omega-3 fatty acids essential for the development of the brain of children. And my grandmother kept me eating these eggs. Now, these are eggs in 2000. 20 times more omega-6s than omega-3s. Eggs have become a pro-inflammatory food. And nobody told you that. So when you go to the supermarket, look for omega-3 eggs. And these, they're not eggs that have been injected with fish oil. They're normal eggs. You know, these eggs should be marked as pro-inflammatory omega-6 eggs. And the normal eggs should just say normal eggs. They shouldn't say omega-3 eggs. This is what happened over millions of years. You see, as hominids developed, there was always a balance in their food between omega-6s and omega-3 fatty acids. And then something happened around 1945 when we started increasing omega-6s in the diet of animals and therefore in the diet of people and reducing omega-3s. Now think about a lawnmower. Most of you have operated one at one point or another or looked at somebody operate one. They need to be filled with just the right proportion of gasoline and oil. If you play around with the proportions and they're not right, the engine is going to sputter and may not function at all. This is what we're doing. We have a biology that is meant to function with this mix. This is the mix we're putting in. It created problems. The main problem is this one. Remember, omega-6s stimulate cell growth. Now, the only cells that can grow in an adult body are fat and cancer. We're seeing this, for sure. In fact, I'm going to show you something reasonably dramatic. This is the map of the country you love and care about. And I do too. And this is the map of obesity, you know, a BMI over 30. This is marked obesity. This is not just a little bit of overweight. In 1985, this is the year I arrived in Pittsburgh to do my PhD. Pittsburgh's right here. People looked normal in Pittsburgh in 1985. This is the map in 1985. Some states had less than 10% obesity. Some had already between 10 and 14% obesity, darker blue. And then this is what we did to ourselves that I want you to take a look at. 1986, 1987, 1988, 1989, 1990, 1991, 1992. First states with 15 to 20%, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, states with more than 20% obesity, 98, 99, 2000, 2001, states with more than a quarter of the people obese, 2002, 2003, in 2004, 2005, the first states with more than a third of the people obese, 2006,
a third of the people.
2007.
And this only goes to 2007.
Remember, obesity is one of the leading risk factors for cancer. Of course, people don't get cancer as soon as they become obese. It takes 10 to 20 years. So this may be the map and the progression of cancer rates in our country over the next 10 to 20 years, if we don't do something about that.